world in his hand. Believe that tonight. He is still the beginning and the end. Hey. He still guides the sparrow as it flies. But you and I are still the apple of his eyes. Still we will believe.
We will believe the report.
That's coming from the kingdom of God. It's always a time when we get up early in the morning, go before the Lord, hear what he has to say to us. We have to speak unto you guys on today. We got our guest in the office today, in the studio today here. My wife is co-pastor Patty Ellis here. He's going to be in the word with us this morning. And we just want to kind of let the music solidify itself this morning as we go forth to hear what the kingdom of God has to say that's coming from the kingdom of God. We're going to be in Psalms 46. We're going to be there with some of the things that God calls us to be in our habitats and having problems. He's a very present help in a very present time of need. So we just want to set back here with the word of God has to say. It's coming from the kingdom of God. And once again, we thank you for joining us. For those who didn't have a chance or don't have the opportunity to get on the slide, we want you to go to our actual website, which is harvestnewlifechurch.com. And there's a sign to call Spreaker. If you can take that and paste it into your browser, you can come onto the show live and hear what we have to say to the kingdom of God and the word is coming forth. If not, later on, this is a 24-hour episode. You can go back any time of the day and listen to it. Not just on actually live time, but you can listen to it 24-7 and hear what the word is coming from here at Harvest New Life Church. Remember, that's going to be harvestnewlifechurch.com. You're going to go to schedules and services. You're going to look and see an icon says Spreaker. You're going to take that Spreaker, you're going to place it into your browser, it's going to bring it to the Spreaker show. For those of you who have cell phones, you're going to have to go to your cell phone to load the app to get this actual show going. We are mostly all the, what you saw, the social networks, from Boxster to Twitter, and this show goes all the way across the seas here, Africa, Germany. We got a quite a vibrant audience that we actually speak the word of God to the season which we're in. We're not going to delay the time. We're going to move forward here with the word of God has to say that's coming from the kingdom. We thank each and every one of you for joining us this morning. The next time I come back on the line, my voice, next time I come on, we'll be lifting up the word of God and hear what the kingdom has to say that's coming from the kingdom of God. We bless and thank you guys for the opportunity just being with us here at Harvest New Life Church here in the city of Dallas.
No matter what the world says.
Father God, we thank you, we bless you, we honor you for coming before your throne this morning. Father God, we thank you as you looked over us all night long, Father God. As we slept and slumbered, Father God, and woke up to see a day which we've never seen before. Father God, I just got to give you thanks. Because you are decreed in your word, Father God. We don't know the time, place, or when. But even as we lay down at night, Father, and give you the praise for seeing the very day which we never saw before. And depending on you, Father God, even in the midst of what seemed to be diversity and there seemed to be some things that's in our life that we just don't quite understand. Well, Father God, your word said cast all of our cares on you, Father God, because you say you're the one to care for us. And Father God, we thank you for this opportunity, Father God, that you raise us up this morning, Father God, to get a brand new start, Father God. And with that brand new start, Father God, we give you praise. The Bible says you ought to give God praise. You ought to clap your hands when you come before God. That even we rise up this morning, we saw our children saved. We saw every circumstance in our life that ever tried to come against us. We saw it in the midst of whenever the death angel tried to come in, whenever the angel of whatever it may have been tried to come in and stop us. You kept your loving arms around us, Father God, as you put the four angels on the edge of a house, and as the angel began to roam up and down in our homes, looked over us, Father God, and kept us in the midst that we were slumbering. And the blood was steady flowing warm in our veins, Father God, and the heart that you created continued to pump. Father God, it's such a blessing, Father God, that even we rose up this morning, Father God, to take the breath. You know, we came back into our natural consciousness in the name of Jesus. To be in your presence, Father God, to declare the word that's coming from you, Father God, that we may know and understand, Father God, that there's not nothing too hard for you to do, and that everything and all things are possible. Father God, we ask you to redeem us in the name of Jesus. But even when it seems like things are not moving in our direction, Father God, you are decreed according to your word, Father God, that we shall look toward you, Father God, in heaven. And we depend on you, Father God, as being our Father. You are our Father who in heaven, Father God, and you gave us every opportunity on the day, every breath we breathe, Father God, every limb we move, every step we take. We thank you, Father God, because you are God, and besides you, there's no other. But Father God, I thank you for the beautiful woman of God you put in my life to stand beside me in the studio as we go forth the tag team that comes from the kingdom of God. And we give a double blessing into the earth, and the people who has an ear to hear, they will hear what the Spirit of the Lord has to say. So many things are going on in the life of your people, Father God, I can't even announce it all. But I declare by the word of God, by the kingdom of God, Father God, you said you look high, you set high, you look low. That every circumstance that ever occurred in anybody's life, every hindrance situation, whatever took place in the individual's life, Father God, you said that you're the refuge. And you said that you're the very present help and the very present time of need. Father God, I thank you for this opportunity to come before you, Father God, and just be able to minister your word to your people. In such a tedious time, Lord, all the events that's going on around the world, Lord, war going and war, rumors of war, and different diversities of men want to take over men, want to rule over men. Even our churches ain't crisis, Father God. But we ask you, Father God, as you continue to go forth, bring up those soldiers, Father God, avenge us, Father God, in the need, in the time of need. They don't want to seem like the enemy is coming against us. Father God, avenge us. Search our hearts, Father God. Take us to where you want us to be, Father God. Let not our sleepless night come into place of where we are. And even in the midst of where we are, Father God, we will know that through you, Father God, that everything and all things are possible. Father God, we thank you. We bless you. We honor you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And we decree according to the kingdom of God, there's not one weapon formed against us to prosper. And nothing will be able to stand. Father God, we declare it, Father God. We decree it. As we break down every stronghold, Father God, that the enemy tries to come against us and make it feel other than what you said. Every sickness and every disease that ever try to engulf our body, we declare by the kingdom of God has got to line up according to the Spirit. And know that you, Father God, there's not one weapon formed, created, or fashioned against us that shall prosper. And nothing will be able to stand. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity. As we come before your throne in the name of Jesus, we decree this word right now, Father God. And know that you, Father God, in everything, I mean everything, all things are possible. Because we believe according to the kingdom. We thank you for this day that you give us opportunity just to be in the land of the living. Have one more chance, Father God, to cry out to you, Abba, Father. Help us in the midst of our crisis, in the midst of our situation. Help us to take off the mask, Father God. Help us to take off the facade of what we're trying to be or something that we're not. And we may get the full effect of the illumination of the Spirit that you continue to touch us, Father God, in every confusing area in our life. Lord, we decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we pray, Father God, we know that to you, Father God, that everything and all things are possible. We thank you, Father God, for this word.
As we go forth, let the word cleave to our hearts. Let it cleave to us, Father God, in the midst of our bowels, in the midst of our belly, in the midst of our heart. Pull back the callus, Lord. Take the stiffness off of our ears, Father God, off our necks, that we may understand and realize that you, our God, has never forgot about us. Father God, I thank you that you know the thoughts and the plans that you have for us. Father God, you say they're good and not of evil. Expected future by the power and the revelation of your Holy Spirit. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity. We thank you, Father God, for keeping your loving arms around us, Father God, and knowing that through you, Father God, that everything and all things are possible. For we believe these things I speak not of myself, but the power of the Most High God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray, Lord, amen. We thank you once again for being with us here at Harvest. New Life Church, doing Harvest, New Life Studios. It's always an opportunity to come before you guys to hear what the Word of God has to say that's coming from the kingdom. I ask God to just continue, just keep me behind the cross. Don't let me try to appear to be something that I'm not. And as I go forth with what God has declared in my life, that I continue to move on a path that He's designed. So we thank you for just joining us and being a part of us. We know we love the Lord. We ask all of you who joining us, and we love you as well. We may not get back to you in the times we need to get back to you, things that's going on, but we know that that's a magnificent word that comes from the kingdom of God. And we know through this word, God has designed and engineered us to do this work, even as we move forward in what seemed to be the eyes of individuals being impossible. But we want to move over to the book of Psalms 46, and we want to let you get there in your chapters, or go to Psalms 46. We're going to look at verse 1, and we want to just really just just elaborate and kind of just look at the first part of this magnificent word, this powerful word. And we're going to look at it on both sides of the King James Version as well as the Amplified Version. We're going to get some supporting scriptures, and we want to really just tackle this, because I know there's a lot of people who's going through things in their life and they don't seem to understand how God is going to bring them out. But I heard the Word of God say, I'm the God of the impossibility. That I'm a God that could do everything and all things. There's nothing too hard for me to do. So we thank God for this opportunity as we come before the throne to hear that's what say the Lord has to say on this morning. We thank you once again for joining us as the Word of God read for the hearing of the listeners. It says over in Psalms 46 that God is a refuge. We want to just look at that word refuge. And even when it seems like you see these great ships and these crashes and these events that take place in the lives of people, it's always some kind of rescue squad there to be able to look after them and aid them. Even when we see some of these magnificent storms that hit these islands, and some of these typhoons, some of these very storms that just hurl across these very levels of territories and just wipe everything out. And you see the very aid of the Red Cross. You see the very ambulance that come along. And God say, I'm much more greater than that, than the storms that wipes out the physical land. I'm great more. I'm more than the very things that come against your life. I'm a God, the creator of the universe, and I am your refuge. And I want you to look at me as being a leaning post in the name of Jesus. That even when I said in my word that our God, that God is a refuge and he's a very present help, that word present, that means right now, as soon as it come out of your mouth, you got attached to that presence of Mark 9:23. Because it says to him that believe, everything and all things are possible. The Bible declares and decrees that in the midst of your trouble, he's the help. He's the only one that got the ability to bring you out of whatever it is that you're in. It doesn't matter what it looked like in your own eyesight. Or what we read over even in the book of Isaiah, over in the 53rd chapter, that God declares and decrees that he was wounded for our transgressions and he was bruised.